Okay, this way. welcome to Grossbeck Homecoming 2023. The Grossbeck X Students Association, Blackshear Washington Association, Grossbeck Independent School District, and especially Grossbeck High School welcome one and all to this year's homecoming and our pregame activities. We will start the pregame activities with a presentation of our 2023 Parade Marshal, Mr. Tom Hawkins. Sometimes known as Mr. Homecoming, Tom Hawkins has been a longtime citizen of the community and involved in all organizations and boards, as well as was the previous owner and editor emeritus of the Grossbeck Journal. Tom has a true love for homecoming, and it has always been one of his favorite times of year. He was honored with a reception at the Grossbeck Journal office this afternoon and will be leading the parade tomorrow morning in downtown Grossbeck. Congratulations, Tom Hawkins, and thanks for all you do. Mr. and Mrs. Homecoming 2023 is Mrs. Marcia Scott Turner and Mr. William C. Turner. Marcia is in the class of 1973, and William is in the class of 1971. Both are graduates of Grossbeck High School. Marcia and William married shortly after high school. They are proud parents of Lawrence Smith Jr. of Reno, Nevada, and Crystal Turner of Las Vegas, Nevada. After traveling for many years in the military, William made a career in the Navy. They chose Las Vegas, Nevada to make their home. Marcia and William are proud grandparents of 8 grandchildren and 3 great-grandchildren. Marcia is the daughter of the late Mrs. Helen Scott and Mr. James Scott Sr. William is the son of the late Mrs. Lonnie Faye Turner Jackson and Mr. Chester Turner. Marcia and William are members of the New Jerusalem Worship Center with Bishop James M. Rogers as the pastor in Las Vegas, Nevada. Marcia proudly played in the band at Washington High School, and also she was a twirler. She took great pride in being the first black cheerleader at Grossbeck High School. Marcia has been working at Sunrise Hospital for 26 years. After going to cosmetology school, she worked at Fantastic Fan Beauty Salon. William worked for the Coca-Cola Company for 18 years until he retired. Marcia and William enjoy spending time with their children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren, manicuring their beautiful yard and riding around the entertainment capital of the world, downtown Las Vegas, in their nice, shiny Mercedes-Benz. Congratulations, William and Marcia, Mr. and Mrs. Homecoming 2023. This year's 2023 X Students Queen is Lisa De Cordova. Lisa is a graduate of the Grossbeck class of 1973. She is the proud mother of 3, daughter Michelle and husband Mike Terry, son Keith and wife JJ Rand, and daughter Nicole and husband Derek Pringle. She is also the proud nana of 7 children, Madison Terry, Jake Pringle, Macy Terry, Kylie Rand, Tyson Pringle, Bryce Rand, and Angel Micah Carey. Lisa is the daughter of the late Russell and Joan De Cordova. Lisa attended Grossbeck High School from 5th through 12th grade. In high school, she was very involved. She played tennis, volleyball, and basketball, and was a member of the band, active in student council, and was also a GHS cheerleader. During her time as a student, Lisa was awarded Most Outstanding Teenager of America, Most Attractive, was a class favorite, and also served as an editor of the Chilad. In the fall of her senior year, Lisa was crowned as the GHS football sweetheart. Lisa ran her own wallpapering business in Grossbeck until 1989. In the fall of 1990, Lisa became the assistant to Jim Longbotham for the Grossbeck High School and Junior High tennis team. and worked in the position until 1995, when she would take an employment at the Limestone County District Attorney's Office until spring of 99. Later that year, Lisa moved to Dallas to pursue a job as a paralegal at Norton Rose Fulbright, and she worked there until her retirement in May of 2018. Lisa is loved by everyone who knows her, the kids she coached, her coworkers, her friends, and most of all, her family. She enjoys traveling with her amazing daughters, hens, chicks, and family. In March of 2021, Lisa was able to go on a mother-daughter trip to Hawaii, which she will always remember as one of the most fun times of her life. She takes pride in all of her accomplishments that her kids and grandkids have achieved, and is excited about her oldest granddaughter's upcoming wedding and the addition of a new grandson to her family. Congratulations, Lisa de Cordova. Grosbeck High School Class of 1973 is this year's honor class. We proudly welcome the Class of 1973 to Homecoming 2023. The class is expected to ride in the Homecoming Parade tomorrow. The class will be presented with their 50-year diplomas following the Homecoming Luncheon, which will be held at the Grosbeck Convention Center starting at 11:30 tomorrow, September 16th. Congratulations to the Grosbeck High School Class of 1973. Tonight, we honor all current and past FSA members and their staff. The group is expected to ride in the Homecoming Parade tomorrow. As well, we are also honoring all qualifying and state players that either qualified for state or went to state in any sport while they were at Grosbeck High School. A special reception will be held at Inge Washington Gym, the old junior high white gym, tomorrow following the Blackshear Washington High School historical dedication and unveiling at 1 o'clock between the Red Goat Cafe and the Kids Care Cafe. As part of the pregame activity, the GHS band will be thrilling us with its excellent halftime show. During the actual halftime, the Grosbeck High School Homecoming Queen and nominees will be presented. Again, we welcome all of you to Grosbeck Homecoming 2023. We'd also like to extend a special thank you to Lauren Spencer for being our limo driver this evening and taking care of all of our alumni. We appreciate her sincerely. Thanks to everyone else that made everything possible tonight. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Grosbeck High School is proud to present the award-winning Grosbeck High School Marching Band. The band will present for you portions of the first half of its UIL marching show entitled Season Change. Randall Standridge's reimagining of Antonio Vivaldi's The Four Seasons. We now present for you Spring and Summer. Our band students. A huge thank you also goes to the Grosbeck Band Boosters for their continued support and hard work for all of our students. Please visit the concession stands near the fieldhouse to help support the GISD band program. Again, welcome to Homecoming 2023.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to tonight's matchup for homecoming between the Crockett Bulldogs and your Groesbeck Goats. I want to welcome all of our former students and alums to tonight's ball game, and want to remind everyone this game is being conducted according to the rules and regulations of the UIL. Regardless of the outcome of tonight's game, all of the players have proven their willingness to work and sacrifice in order to achieve athletic excellence. Cheer these young athletes, applaud them, but do not, through any of your actions, cause them to doubt the value of athletics. By your conduct, allow these young people to feel pride in their communities and schools. While your sportsmanlike actions may play only a small part in the outcome of this game, it will play a greater role in the continuing to encourage competitive athletics. We also ask that you show your appreciation for the students who will be taking part indirectly in tonight's game, the cheerleaders, the band, and the students who have supported their teams at home and away. These young people play an integral part in their team's success. The officials for tonight's game have been mutually agreed upon by school officials for both schools. Their role is not unlike those of players, coaches, teachers, and school administrators. Without them, this game would not be possible. Their knowledge and application of the rules are a result of annual testing, years of study, and continual participation in clinics to further refine their understanding of the game. We ask you, as students, parents, and citizens, to demonstrate the kind of respect for these officials you would extend to any dedicated person in a position of responsibility. This means that you as a fan should not criticize the players on either team, should not boo the officials, should not have alcoholic beverages on public school grounds, as it is a violation of state law, should be courteous to the visiting fans, cheer for your team, and show respect for injured players on both teams. Groesbeck Stadium is a tobacco vape-free stadium, as are all public school facilities in Texas. This includes the parking lot outside the stadium. If you leave for any reason, there is a no real injury policy. Please refrain from standing in the walkways throughout the stadium, and do not stand along the railing at any time during the game. Keep your children seated with you in the interest of safety for all. At the request of high school administration and coaching staff, there are to be no spectators on the field, including the track area, before, during, or after the game. Only participants and school officials, as well as credentialed individuals, will be allowed on the field. Lastly, parents and families, please meet your players in front of the field house after the game. Players will not come back into the stadium to exit. Rockhead Band. Whenever you are ready, we would love to hear your school song. Mr. Anderson, when you're ready. Thank you. captains are heading to midfield. Captains for the Goats tonight, number 63, Buddy Silvera. Number 0, Kenny Bennett. Number 7, Trent Platt. And number 34, Ryder Bagley. Captains for the Bulldogs, number 4, Damon Dixon. And number 60, Artis Edwards. The Goats have won the toss. They will receive and defend the south end zone. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would please rise. Gentlemen, remove your hats for the quick word of prayer followed by the playing of the national anthem. This evening's color guard is being provided by the Navasota Valley Young Marines. Young Marines are carrying the flag tonight are Gunny Sergeant Leanna Mackey with the United States flag and Sergeant Tawny Treese with the Texas. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to once again come together and take part in the tradition we all hold dear. We pray that you allow these athletes to perform their very best and glorify you in their work. Guide their dedications unto you, and rather than play with individuality, they play with their team and the community. I pray for the safety of the players and the clarity of their minds, regardless of the outcome of tonight's game. We pray and honor you, Lord, for your glory. Amen. Sophomore band member Hunter Garner for leading us in our prayer tonight. Jordan Smith and Chris Cox back deep to receive the opening kick for the Goats. Number 14, Angel Arbizu in the kick for the Bulldogs. It's Friday night under the lights. It's Texas High School football. Welcome to Groves Beck Stadium, ladies and gentlemen, for the homecoming between the Goats and the Bulldogs. Rocket opens the game with an onside kick and recovers it. The offense takes over first and 10 from the 47. Jameson Brantley there to break it up for the Goats. Incompletion will make it. Fourth down and long for Crockett. Cruz in the punt. Chris Cox back deep. Ball takes a Crockett bounce and is down at the 14-yard line. So the offense takes over first and 10. At the 25 for the first time tonight. That's a first down. Growth bag. Woo! Reagan sent Carruthers into the backfield. It's a tackle on flat. Ball spotted at the 23-yard line. It'll be second down and 12. Flag on the play. Illegal substitution on the Goats. We will mark off the penalty and retry the down. For the Goats. Davis is the lane and McKnight back into the seat. Davis returns the kick for the Bulldogs. Cade Carroll there to make the tackle for the Goats. Crockett offense takes over first and 10 from the 43. Porter on the carry. Wesley Bush there to make the tackle for the Goats. Second down and one from the 48. Tied to Lane on the carry. Goat defense makes a stop at the 46-yard line. That's the first down for the Bulldogs. Ball spotted at the 38. It'll be second down and two. Carry. Davion Baker there to make a tackle for the Goats. With the ball at the 30, it'll be fourth down and long. a big first down. Rosebud. Fans at 1 p.m. tomorrow, Blackshear Washington High School historical dedication and unveiling between the Red Hill Cafe and the White Gym. The reception will follow with a special presentation at Ames Washington Gym. An honor will be held for all qualifying and state players in any sport from GHS, as well as a special presentation honoring an annual community honoree. Marion Davis returns the kick for the Bulldogs. He's taken out of bounds at the 32. Bulldog offense will take over at first and 10. Defense under heavy pressure makes the stop at the 30-yard line. Makes the second down as well. Rock! Pope. There make the tackle at the 31. That'll make the fourth down. Heavy pressure from DeCorian Butler. Flat pass falls incomplete. That's a first down. Groesbeck. Cannon Campbell, he's taken out of bounds at the 44. Keith Gibson on the carry. He's finally taken down at the 34-yard line. That's another first down. Groesbeck. Jackson again on the carry. Powers his way down to the 28-yard line. Second down and four for the Goats. Until he gets to the 11-yard line. And that's a first down. Goes there. Also, the penalty pushes the Goats back to the 26-yard line. His way down to the 9-yard line. Sean Rayfield there to make the tackle for Crockett. Gibson again on the carry. Bulldogs make the tackle at the 5. for the goal. The lane back deep for Crockett. For the first down. On the keeper, Tyrion Reagan's there to make the tackle. On the keeper, bowls his way inside the 10. First down and goal for the Goats. pass complete to Ramirez. Fumble on the play. Goats recover. And the Goats use their first timeout. We have an injured player on the field. Gibson on the carry, tripped up at the three. Gibson again on the carry, stopped just short of the goal line. Simon returns the kick for the Bulldogs. Goes there to make the tackle at 26. Crockett takes over, first and 10. Lane on the carry. Goes there to make the tackle at the 37. There to make the tackle for the goal. Officials mark the ball at the 45-yard line. Along the play, recovered by the goat. First down, throws back. Pass intended for Chris Cox, falls incomplete. Chris Cox on the reception for the Goats. Steps out of bounds at the 15. Jimenez in to attempt the field goal for the Goats. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On the field for your halftime entertainment is the Big Blue Band from Bulldog Land. The band is under the direction of Mrs. Dana Moore, J.R. Martinez, and assisted by drum tech Ruben Sanchez. Drum majors for the Bulldog Band are Marcus Moore, Donna Jean Colbert, and field captain Susan Martinez. The band will perform Fanfare for a New Age, General Lee March, and The Expert by Vandercook. Thank you. Bulldogs. Good evening and welcome to the 2023 Groesbeck High School Homecoming Halftime Show. Please turn your attention to the 50-yard line for our homecoming court presentation. Our first nominee for homecoming queen is Janae Troche. Janae is escorted by her father, Jason Troche. Janae is the daughter of Micah and Jason Troche, granddaughter of Teresa Heil and Nancy and Bobby Willingham. Janae has participated in FFA, National Honor Society, Student Council, and Fellowship of Christian Athletes. She is a member of the varsity softball team, varsity cheer squad, and participates in powerlifting. Janae says that a big part of her life is her commitment to the show ring. She has been showing pigs since the fifth grade. After graduation, Janae plans to attend Weatherford College and continue both her academic and athletic career as a member of their softball team. She plans to pursue a degree in animal science and then apply for veterinarian school at Texas A&M. Our first homecoming nominee, Janae Troche. Next up is Grace Roman. Grace is escorted by her father, James Roman, and is the daughter of Tina and James Roman. Grace is a member of the Groesbeck High School Arts Club, currently serving as president, is a student council member, and participates in the high school visual arts scholastic event where she advanced to area last year. After graduation, Grace plans to study interior design. Grace Roman. Our next nominee is Soraya Smith. Soraya is escorted by Alfred Jackson. Soraya is the daughter of Valerie Lewis and Alfred Jackson Jr., granddaughter of Sherry and Lizelle Lewis and Brenda and Alfred Jackson. Soraya has been an active member in student council, FFA, and Gear Up during her time at GHS. She's a member of the softball and volleyball team, participates in track, is a member of the varsity cheer squad, participates in powerlifting, where she advanced to the state meet last year. After graduation, Soraya plans to attend Barrow College to become a registered nurse, and then plans to attend UT in Austin to become a nurse anesthetist. Soraya Smith. Next nominee is Winnie Lynn. Winnie is escorted by her father, Air Lynn, and is the granddaughter of Abby and Air Lynn. Winnie is a member of National Honor Society, Student Council, participates in Gear Up and Band, as well as UIL Academics. Winnie will be a first-generation college student. She is the drum major for the DHS band, serves as vice president of NHS, and has served as treasurer of the student council. Highlight of her high school career includes scoring a 1530 on the SAT and receiving rural recognition for her PSAT score. Winnie has already earned her certificate as a certified nursing assistant, volunteers at Limestone Medical Center, helps with NHS bake sales, volunteers for National Night Out, Food for Families, Toys for Tots, and the Sweet Seat Project. After graduation, Winnie plans to attend a four-year university to major in pre-med or math or both. Miss Winnie Lynn. Next up is Charlie Agnew. Charlie is escorted by her father, Murray Agnew, is the daughter of Brandy and Murray Agnew, granddaughter of Glenda and Bill Palm, and Marvin and Gail Agnew. Charlie has been part of several organizations during her time at GHS. She's currently the Student Council President, NHS Secretary, FFA Advisor, and is on the Gear Up Council. Charlie competes in ag issues and dairy cattle judging at FFA events, as well as show steers. After graduation, Charlie plans to attend Texas A&M, pursuing a pre-med major with a minor in psychology. Following her undergraduate degree, she plans to attend either law school or medical school to become a licensed psychiatrist or an attorney. Charlie Agnew. Next up is Emma Bays. Emma is escorted by her dad, Berlin Bays, and is the daughter of Sandy and Berlin Bays, granddaughter of Linda Sadler and Bobby Bays. Emma is a member of Student Council, FFA, National Honor Society, and Fellowship of Christian Athletes. Emma is also a member of the varsity tennis team and is on the varsity cheer squad. After graduation, Emma plans to attend Texas A&M to become an RN, followed by getting a CRNA degree to become a nurse and anesthesiologist. Our final nominee is Rainey Samuel. Rainey is being escorted tonight by her father, Pat Samuel. Rainey is the daughter of Pat and Misty Samuels and the granddaughter of Denny and John Benson. Rainey has actively participated in Student Council, FFA, Gear Up, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and National Honor Society while at GHS. Along with these organizations, Rainey competes in track and volleyball. Not only here at Grosbeck, but has played club volleyball for the past 7 years. Last 2 years, earning a spot on the Texas Legends national team. After graduation, Rainey plans on attending Glenn College to become a dental hygienist. Rainey Samuel. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2023 Grosbeck High School Homecoming Queen, Miss Winnie Lynn. Dr. Bonnie Beaumont, GHS Principal, is crowning Miss Lynn on behalf of the 22 Homecoming Queen, LaDaisha Jackson. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 Homecoming Queen, Miss Winnie Lynn. I want to thank all of the ladies for representing Groesbeck High School and the homecoming court proudly tonight. homecoming nominees onto the field for a picture. All homecoming nominees onto the field for a picture. In the kick for the Goats to start the second half. Returns the kick for the Bulldogs. He stopped at the 38. We do have a flag on play. Down and four. the GOAT defense to make the stop just the other side of midfield. That'll make it fourth down for the Bulldogs. We have an injured player on the field. Lockhart on the keeper, fights his way out to the 44, and gets the first down for the Bulldogs. A flag on the play. Officials are marking the ball down at the 25. Holding is the call against the GOAT.
We can't hold on defense.
Penalty is against the Bulldogs. That's going to back them up to the 35. Butler on the carry, stopped at the 31. That's enough distance for the first down. On the keeper. Kate Carroll there to make the tackle for the GOAT. Goes there to make the stop at the 26. Thank you. Hope to make the stop at the 25-yard line. That'll make it fourth down. To the 35-yard line. Offense takes over first and 10.
Thank you.
Jamison Brantley there to make the tackle for the Goats. Lockhart gets the ball out just outside the 40. Lane on the carry, powers his way to the 48 at the first down for Brogdon. Ball start called against the Bulldogs. For the penalty, puts the ball back at the 47. Fumble on the play, recovered by the Goats. Number 23, Cade Carroll, recovers the fumble for Grosbeck. We do have a flag on the play. Holding his call against Crockett, that penalty is declined. That's a Grosbeck first down. Keith Gibson on the carry. Tackle is made at the 29. That'll be second down for the Goats. Gets it on the carry, cranks up the freight train and gets in for the touchdown. Grosbeck.
Stop!
Fumble on the play. And the Bulldogs recover. Flag down on the play. Holding his call against the Bulldogs. Punt is down at the 33. Coach take over first and 10. Ball start on the go. Again on the carry. He stopped at the 49-yard line. Gibson again on the carry for the Goats. Keeps that freight train running downhill to the 45. Yard line. touchdown pass at the 30. It's a first down, Roseback. Matthew Valentine there to make the tackle for the Ghost. We have two flags on the play. Thank you. big for Crockett out to the 39-yard line. Simon on the carry, taken out of bounds at the 38. Again on the carry, fights his way out to the 46. Officials rule that forward progress was stopped. Ball spotted at the 40-yard line.
Watch him up center, boys, let's go!
Bring it down in two.
There we go.
Isaiah Galvan into the backfield for the Ghost. Gets the tackle for a loss at the 42 and a half yard line.
Go D, let's
go! Delane on the carry. Goes to make the stop at the 42. Delane on the carry once again. John Ramirez there to make the tackle. Simon on the carry. Taken out of bounds by the Goats at the 30. Lane once again on the carry. Officials place the ball just inside the 30. That'll be third down. Fights his way inside the 20. That'll be a first down for the Bulldogs. And Crockett uses the timeout. Sanchez coming off the bottom of the pile for the Goats. Third down and long. Bennett and Bush there to make the stop for the Goats.
Bagley leads the Goat defense to make the stop.
change of possession will give the Gophers first down from the 17. Davis returns to kick the target. Goats make the tackle at the 27. There to make the stop at the 39. No gain. Second down and 10 for Crockett. Kenny Bennett there to make the tackle for the goal. Stop made at 46. Pass is intended for Simon, falls incomplete. We do have a flag on the play. The Bulldogs call a timeout. Pass interference called against the Goats. That'll give Crockett a first down from the 39. False start called against the Bulldogs. On the carry, Elijah Connick leads the go defense, making stop at the 43. Lockhart on the carry, stopped at the 36-yard line. caught it at the 32-yard line. That's the ball game, ladies and gentlemen. Your goat victorious over the Crockett Bulldogs. I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight and supporting all these boys, as well as welcoming back our alumni for Grove Bank Homecoming. We'll see everybody tomorrow morning for the parade.